नमस्कार। इन दिस वीडियो ऑफ ई ऑफिस इंग्लिश सीरीज वी विल सी सम बेसिक्स ऑफ पीडीएफ कंप्रेशन एंड मर्जर। व्हाई दिस टॉपिक इज नीडेड हियर, बिकॉज एज डिजिटाइजेशन बीइंग डन बाय वेरियस डिपार्टमेंट्स इन विच स्कैनिंग वर्क ऑफ फाइल्स, नोटशीट्स एटसेट्रा, देयर वी नोटिस्ड एंड क्वेरीज ऑल्सो केम दैट दे क्रिएटेड स्कैंड कॉपी ऑफ पेजेस सेपरेट सेपरेट, विच इज अ रॉन्ग प्रैक्टिस। Single PDF is must for note sheet and same in case of correspondence that I showed in the first video of digitization. So note sheet and correspondence will be in their folders in one single copy, either it have one page or 100 of pages. Otherwise you will be in trouble when uploading work will come. So this topic has been chosen before going to next topic. So there are various ways to do merging, and it's not like that we need to do scanning again of the same pages from start. That's why I have taken this topic here so that it will resolve the problem. So first we'll go to our browser and type PDF joiner and press enter. First result, pdfjoiner.com will come. Click on it. Very simple to use. For showing example, I created three random files, 1.pdf, 2.pdf, 3.pdf files. If I open it, in 1.pdf, it is written, this is first page. In 2.pdf, this is second page. And in 3.pdf, this is third page. It is in Hindi language, no issues. So we have three separate PDF files. Let's try to merge these to see if it creates single PDF or not. Now come to PDF joiner site and click on upload files button. Go to place to find those files which we need to merge. Just browse it. Okay, where I have kept, yeah. Select all the files together. Click on open button. See, all came here and the uploading started. Let it get uploaded. Please check the order as the file come here in any order. Currently it is 1, 2, 3. It's the correct one. Order is correct. But sometimes order may be different. So what we need to do in that case, this website provides us the facility to move it. See, 2 came here, 3 came here, 1 at last. So I just want to show that the files we can move very easily. So final order should be correct. So 1, 2, 3 is the final order. Now below is the button of joining files. So click on join files button. See, one file will come as a download, new download with name PDF joiner. You can see it. Let's see what is inside it. Okay, just click on the file that got downloaded. Let it get opened. See above here, it is total 3 pages. Okay, now this is the first page. Then below, this is second page, and the last one is the third page, means we can easily do merging. Note here that these websites are having servers in foreign countries. We don't know anything about the security. So joining government files, in that also two confidential files and other files too, should not be merged using such tools. If your department do not recommend, it may not be permitted. So be careful. Now we see some department did scanning, but size is very huge due to wrong setting of scanner quality. So they can do again scanning with proper quality setting, or they can use the PDF compress. So I have typed in Google PDF compress and just press enter. So let results come. It is taking time because of internet speed. Let it come. First result will come. So we will choose pdfcompressor.com is the file name. Yeah, it opened. Just click on it. Now may click on upload files button and browse the file which we want to compress. File will get uploaded and it will show one download button, and I'm clicking on it. It will download the compressed less file size. It's very easy. It is just like that. You can do it very easily. Again, be careful about permission to use these websites in your organization. Now one query came on last video on receipts, that when we log in e-office file management system, there by default shows file inbox screen, and if there is nothing came to us and if came to the receipt section, then how we will come to know? For a layman user, for a new user, how he will come to know that receipt, in receipt he has received? So it's very simple. For showing that, let login once. Here we, I'm clicking on login button. So let it get login. We used to go to file management system link, but before that, here see notification screen came. It is good for us that it is showing that something came for us, that too before entering into file management system. It is a kind of alert system. Secondly, it is already showing receipt number has come, so you know that it has come. But we have other option also, so we'll go to our system as we used to do earlier, file management system. Let it get opened. Wait. Okay, this message is coming because somebody already logged in with the same ID. He is maybe doing practice. Let me come out and try again. Okay, let me click on it. Wait. Okay, again it is coming. Let me click on yes. It will log out the other person. So it will struggle. Let close it, the coming screen. Okay, yeah. By default close this and go to the received inbox. See inbox, received inbox here. Here in brackets will return number of received schemes. So currently it is not there, so it's not showing that bracket. It is not such a big query, but good that questions are coming in mind of viewers and users. Now I want to mention that in receipts video there, the letter received for District Urban Administration Department, we entered many of the details like letter date, received date. But there I missed a very important field, that is letter reference number. It is very important field and we must put it as we in future search letter from letter number, because it is a generally we get letter number for searching. So it is not mandatory field, maybe because of this I forgot to fill it in last video, in that video, but it should be filled. So I want to cover this point. So I took this point in this video. If letter number is available, it should be filled, right? Because you usually say we get reference number, that in that reference letter it was there, and like that we get messages for communication. So we should keep it if it is available. For this letter, of course I want to show where is letter number. It is a normal thing. Just a second. Let me go above this letter, which is not coming correctly. Yeah, here this one is the letter number, right? This one is the 2823 or 25 something, which is the letter number. That's all I want to show in this video. So in receipts we cover all the points here except email diarization. It is that we have our government email IDs. When it will get mapped with our e-office account, then we can access our email, all the emails directly here only. We need not to go to browser and open our email, and can take directly any file that came through email in our e-file system and initiate our work as normal in file management system, right? This I cannot show here currently, as email is not configured in this demo version. When it will be configured, on clicking the email diarization link, we will see our inbox here in right side. So in this topic under receipts is also completed. I'm not sure demo, but I cannot right now because it is not possible at this point of time. So now I come out. Just a second, let me come out of this. As this screen is very familiar to you. I want to show here that notification here is minimized. If I click here, it shows two alerts for us, but it shows limited alerts, two or three, right? If I want to see more, click on anyone. Here the details will come. Let it get uploaded. Sorry, let it get downloaded. Yeah. See, this is showing what alerts today, yesterday, or previous days alerts can be seen and checked. If we are regular checking our e-files, then no need to check alerts. But if you are coming after leaves, then may be useful to see the all the alerts. Here one more thing, that there are many features, some of maybe I am missing, but if you will come here, you will notice all the things when you log in. Now see, in this screen, what I want to show here, what is this E? E is actually stands for electronic. File management system works in two ways. Some offices use this only for tracking purpose and move their files physically, but enter only basic details like file is moving from whose table to whose table, whom it is marked, etc. In that case, here P comes. It is for physical. So just I have shared this for your knowledge. Now click on this receipt number. Okay, so I have clicked on this receipt number. The details will come. You know this screen very well. I want to show this attach file option. I'll click on this screen will come showing all files at our levels. Currently, yeah, only one file is there showing A-21021 etc. etc. file number. Let attach it to see what happens. So click on this. In your office, you do attach, detach, or close for everything. You need to give some reasons, and all this gets recorded. So now I click the attach button. Clicking on it, now it will ask for remarks. See here, I am writing. It is a related file and testing. Then click OK button. See, it will come here. Just a second, it is showing, yeah, here it is showing now details of attached files and my remark we just entered. On clicking this file number, yes, it will open file in new pop-up screen. It is to note that if browser pop-up is disabled, then this screen would not come and we will be confused that nothing is happening on clicking the file number. So let me show till file is getting loaded here. Minimizing this pop-up, click three horizontal lines on browser, go to options, go to content, yes, content, then this pop-ups field, uncheck it in your system if it is checked. Now see, we'll go to this option, you understand, huh? Now we'll go to the pop-up to see the what has been got downloaded. Yeah, this file we will discuss in next video, what is this left green part and what is this white file part on right side. Similarly, if you attach wrong file, so what can be done? It can be removed from here as well. This cross sign is there, right? We'll again need to put remarks. Let write testing. Testing is done. Okay, we can write it in Hindi also. Click OK button. So file got detached. Okay, see now detached, no records found is written, no records found is written in attached and detached files, but below that history is showing of what file has been detached. Testing is done is written. Similarly, as we attached file, we can attach receipts. So through this video we covered some basics of merging, compressing PDF files. We covered some left out very small points. I request to use these compression merger tools after consultation with your higher authorities only, as only deep government departments are working on this. So the purpose of the video was to make you comfortable by showing some of the features and points which came in my mind before preparing this video, so that your working on e-office file management system will be a little bit smoother. And when you'll do practice, you'll find a lot of things correlated with what I've told, and slowly you will become master of this. E-office is a big system having so many modules, but file management system is important for us. These are my email IDs. You can ask any query, but preferably this Gmail ID is preferable. Thank you. Thank you.